I am Ryerson's motion picture lab operator. The official title is film production and preservation technician. I have this very unique role of running our film students' motion picture lab. In particular, this lab probably has a lot in common with the origins of motion picture processing because we process black and white film here. The first year students just have access to black and white motion picture stock. Our machine is designed just to do black and white film. So it's actually a fairly simple process. The advantage of this 1969 model processor is simply that it would mechanize the transportation of film through these chemical baths. I think in the early days you'd see images of motion picture labs would simply have wooden racks with the film sort of wrapped around it in a helix, and you'd move the film from one chemical tank to the next. With a machine like this, there's a continuous ribbon of film that goes through all of the tanks one after another. And by the time it gets out of the machine, it's dried off and it's ready to project. When film is pulled from one chemical tank into the next, a certain amount of chemicals carry over on the surface of the film itself. There's this little component. It's small, but it's quite crucial, and it's a set of squeegees that will inhibit chemical carryover, so you don't just end up contaminating every tank of chemistry each time you run. This processing machine is so old that the company long lost interest in supporting it, and so the squeegees that would fit our processor haven't been made in a couple decades at least. What we looked into was making new 3D printed mounts, modifications of the one we already had on the processor, but just a little bit different, a little bit wider in their measurements, so that we could use a different manufacturer's squeegees on our processor.
Most of the work that we do in the fabrication lab revolves around digital fabrication technologies. A lot of it is 3D printing, laser cutting, and then some 3-axis CNC processes as well. So when Mark discovered that the squeegee mounts for his ARRI processor were no longer being produced, he came over to the fab lab to discuss with me the possibilities of using our technologies to solve his problem. Using Rhinoceros 3D, which is a 3D modeling software, we were able to recreate the existing component very specifically, and through a series of measurements and calibrations, we were able to redesign and actually improve the existing part. We took it over to Simplify 3D, which is a slicer software used to prepare files for 3D printing. In Simplify 3D, we were able to adjust the parameters of the physical print that we were going to create to find the right amount of material and infill that would give that squeegee mount the right flexibility while also the strength in order to process the films that Mark was running through his film processor.
Best of times, it can be a bit difficult to understand as a filmmaker, especially a new filmmaker, how to engage with the lab. It's a real luxury, I think, for the students here to be able to have a lab that is quite open doors with them and makes the processes behind the curtain a little more accessible and a little more easy to understand.